Hello, hi everybody. Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Om. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. And I first of all, let me congratulate Hamsa for the wonderful entrepreneur she's become.
Thank you so much, Mom. It's all because of your blessings that this is possible today.
Whatever happens, happens for good, and it happens because God willed it. It came into our life because God willed it. We succeeded because God willed it. We only were a little bit of a catalyst in between. Like for all girls, LPF is a catalyst. It is their destiny which they have to decide. They have to work at it. They have to work hard. We only make it possible for them. And if they do not use this as an advantage to make the best of it, nothing can help them. They have to help themselves. As it's written here in my the best place to find a helping hand is at the end of your own arm. This has been my philosophy right from the beginning, that I have to help myself. Environment gives me the possibilities. Environment gives me the chance. But if I don't take that and I don't put the effort and I don't honestly, sincerely, ethically get down to doing things that I'm supposed to do, I will not succeed. And Hamsa has done exactly that to succeed where she is. And of course, her husband, Chandra, has been there behind, supporting her very much. And they work very well as a team. They work very well as a team. Those of you who have attended this course must have realized that there's a lot of effort gone into developing this. I don't know how many years you took, Hamsa, to develop this course.
It's taken us 5 years, Mom, since we started.
5 years to develop it so that all of you can benefit from it. And those who do not participate in this, they don't know what they're losing. I mean, you feel when you join such programs, you feel, oh my God, I have to do so much time. Forget it. It's not going to be worth it. But it's only when you go through it that you realize how much value you should give to such programs. Not only because you get a good job, but because you become more intelligent. You become more conversant with what's happening in technologies around the world. And that makes you much more enhanced in your approach towards, not only towards your job, but also towards your life. You feel more confident of yourself. You feel that, okay, I'm there. I'm doing exactly what is happening in the world. And that motivates you to enhance further, because you realize that the technology is something that doesn't stop today. It is today, tomorrow is another day, and tomorrow is another technology. Technologies are moving so fast that if you girls don't keep yourself up to the mark, y'all will be left out. So y'all have to continue. I mean, all this, we never had heard of chatbots. Now we had heard about voice designing, now machine learning, now conversational artificial intelligence. These are all subjects which our generation never heard of. You girls are getting a chance, but y'all don't hear what we heard in our time. Because you think, oh my God, what the hell the mom is talking about? Mom doesn't know anything. But I could say the same thing. You don't know anything. You don't know anything of the past. We don't know anything about what's happening now. And if you don't keep yourself up to the mark, you won't know what is happening in the future. So it's your time now to keep yourself upgraded. It's your time to keep yourself up in step with what is happening around the world. And that is what will lead you to your success, each individual. I think there are about different types of projects that you have to go through. You choose your project, and I think that's what I understood. You choose your project and then you work on that project. And with the assistance of the two or three support ladies who are there, who support you with your questions. And then you go through it, and once you succeed with your projects, then you get a certificate. You don't get a certificate otherwise. And in addition to the certificate, Hamsa has now organized a convocation so that you feel good that you're graduated now. It's the feeling. It's the feeling of pride with which you should take this convocation, that I have made it. Not many, many girls get a chance. Your friends, I don't know how many of your friends would have gone through such a certification course. You have been given a chance by the foundation. You have come to the foundation as a part of your, part of our life, our daughters, and you are making good advantage, taking good advantage of making use of all that you have got. So make the best use of it. Do your master projects as you are supposed to do it, sincerely and honestly. If you don't understand, ask. There's no harm done in asking. It's better to ask a stupid question than to keep the doubt inside. It doesn't matter if somebody laughs at your question, it is immaterial. As long as you have cleared your doubts, is what is important, not what others are thinking or saying. Many a times, you know, we avoid asking questions because we feel, oh my God, I'm asking, but maybe everybody else knows, I only don't know. Doesn't matter, I don't know, I need to know, kalas. This should be your attitude, and you should not be ashamed of not knowing something and wanting to get to learn something. With these few words, I wish you all girls best, and I'm sure all of you will make a great success of your career, of your life. And it's not only important that you get a good job, it's important that you become a good person. And you can become a good person if you are confident, if you are honest, if you are ethical, and if you are empathetic. Have empathy towards your friends. Have empathy towards your environment. Have empathy towards what's happening around you. When I say empathy towards your environment, take care of the environment. Don't just mistreat what nature has created. It's very important. See what's happening now with COVID and all that. You must get a message that God is not happy with us. Look at the amount of disasters that are taking place around the world. Fires, floods, rains, earthquakes, accidents. And every time there's a new epidemic. I mean, now it is Delta, then it's going to be Beta, Alpha, God knows what. So you must be very careful. And this is happening because we are not bothered about our environment. We are not caring enough about our environment. We must care for our environment. Try to plant a tree, try to keep some plants at home, look after them, enjoy the nature. Don't just get so engrossed that you don't have time to look around. See how the sun rises, sunset. I'm sure all of you got an opportunity to do that. I know that you all are busy. I know you all are tied up with a lot of online learning and teaching and so many things to pressurize you. But take a few minutes off. Take a few minutes off, thank God for what you have, and take care of the environment to the extent you can. Don't throw things around, don't be nasty with people, don't crush people for nothing. Be empathetic. These are my few words to you, and be successful. Of course, you will be successful if you are a good person. I think this is enough for you today. Take care and always be careful. Don't ignore COVID. COVID is still around. Wear your mask, wash your hands, keep your distance. Don't take it care ki mere ko kuch nahi hoga. It is not for me. I'm quite safe. No, you never know what will happen. So please keep all these precautions you must take. It's your duty to do that, so that you can protect the environment and you can protect your neighbor. Okay, wish you all the best. Take care.
Thank you so much, Mom, for those lovely words. As usual, it's been like so warm and motivating for all of us. I think all girls present here, including myself, are really blessed to have you in our lives. Thank you, Mom, for taking the time out today.
You're most welcome.